Okay. The affirmative side has mentioned a couple times the need for reduction of costs for everyone. They said that their plan will reduce the costs for the citizens. The issue with that is, yeah, you may be able to save some of the cost for the upfront, but the main issue with this is that to fund a system like that with the government has to get money somehow. Where does, according to Kimberly Amadeo, she brings up the idea, where does the federal government get the money to save you that money? It gets it from the taxpayers. Who are the taxpayers? Everyone here. Income taxes contribute $1.68 trillion with it. If the single payer continues, that fund will go up. They brought up before, too, quality of life. That kind of goes single-handedly, you know, side by side with the quality of care that you get. Roger Stark says a single-payer system sounds like a simple solution in the U.S. healthcare problem. The reality is far different. Fundamentally, a single-payer system centralizes all healthcare with the government. It's far too expensive and limits access to healthcare by rationing. Instead of patients and doctors making key decisions, bureaucrats get to make the life and death choices and about the kind and amount of healthcare people receive. Your quality of life is going to be affected by the government instead of the doctors that you trust. And I kind of thought everyone believes in the right to care and all this. While this may be true, there aren't a lot of advocates for the right to care. According to Chris Pope, they did a national review. Single-payer advocates have enthusiastically cited polls showing Americans supporting the expansion of Medicare to cover all Americans. Yet Medicare is not a single-payer system for 86% of the beneficiaries that opt for some form of private or supplementary coverage. Most individuals seeking full coverage outside the multi-payer Medicare Advantage option must purchase supplemental private Medigap plans. Dennis Smith even did a poll that was, they show that most Americans value their current private health care insurance, provided primarily through employers, that they want choices in health coverage, that they're wary of government-run enterprises. If the own citizens are wary of it, where do you get the, everyone's demanding, you know, the right to care if they don't want that in their eyes? And with the quality of care, quality of life, and right to care, Kimberly Amadeo said with free universal health care, people may not be careful with their health. They don't have the financial incentive to do so. Without a copay, people might overuse emergency rooms and doctors. Your quality of life will go down. Your right to care, while you, you know, assume that you do have that, you know, right to your care, the quality of care, the quality of life will therefore decrease.